comes to the iconic slasher villain, can you talk a little about this character and what you feel kind of puts him up there with Jason and Michael and the others you just referenced?
We've given him a
makeover.
We gave him a realistic makeover that happens when he arrives at the morgue. And his outfit had to be cosplayable. You had to be able to look at him, draw him, pick him out. And I felt that with the black pants and the off-green shirt and the first thing, we weren't quite there for what a horror cosplayable icon is. Because anyone could put on black pants and a green shirt, no one's going to say, oh, Jacob, goodnight! But if you see Michael or Freddy or Pinhead, that's them for sure. So we recreated that. We expanded his circle of violence and his array of weapons. And there's one other element that
we gave him a theme song.
He has a theme song. He needed a theme song, right?
And that was from the Newton Brothers, who soundtracked the movie. They're absolutely brilliant. They also soundtracked Oculus, and these guys are great. And they worked so beautifully.
Have you ever watched The Exorcist or Halloween on mute? Not the same effect. No, or Suspiria, then it's someone very slowly walking through really nicely colored scenes.
You're like, hurry up, bitch.
What was it like filming in an actual past mental institute? I heard getting around inside was a little tricky with signs and stuff.
Well, it's still partially open. The criminally insane are still there, which we found out right before we shot across the street from where they're held, because they're like, you have to keep it down, you don't want to scare them. I'm like, why just pop them another blue pill if we're going to be shooting tonight, right?
But so many rights for the criminally insane, my God. Give them a later bedtime, put on a horror movie, what?
I don't like shooting anywhere haunted or even being up at 3 a.m., which is the satanic witching hour, and we had one incident in Riverview, the asylum. There was a rule, there was no touching and no kissing because you didn't want everybody to know. And lots of little crazy people getting born. And so we had
a very diplomatic self, bless you.
I'm very, very, very PC. And there was a scene where we had two characters kiss, and it was weird because we heard bang, bang, bang on the wall only when they kissed.
And Riverview is such a hot spot for filming. We thought it was another crew that was filming that was so loud. We're like, shut them up, my God.
And then someone said, oh, that's air going through the vent, but only when they kissed would it go bang, bang, bang. And then I was like, okay, cut, let's hear it for the bang, bang, bang. Never happened. Only happened when they kissed. I was like, okay, let's get the fuck out of this
and
really fast.
It wasn't a subtle little kick, kick, kick. It was bang, 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 bang.
Yeah, we scared the shit out of ourselves.
Then we started antagonizing them. Can you fucking hold
she
it while I'm trying to shoot?
Started antagonizing them. I don't want to die, okay?
Because if there's going to be a ghost, shouldn't you at least get it on camera?
Yeah,
I mean,
I'm
that
not
would
gonna
be great for BTS.
Yeah, she would be the first girl to die. She'd be like, I won't go anywhere by myself. Are you kidding me?
Please don't take me down with you. You'll come with me.
We're here at Comic-Con. A lot of celebration of the horror genre goes beyond just film and television, including video games. Do you guys keep track of video games at all, and what's going on?
We are hardcore gamers. Our Silent Hill is one of our favorite games ever. I felt the films fell a little short. They should have hired us.
Yeah, exactly.
Obviously.
But we've been gaming since Super Mario 3 on the NES, and we still have our NES, and we still play it. We have a bunch of games and a bunch of systems, and we're also comic book nerds.
Mario Brothers 2. What?
Did you say that?
Yeah,
that's my movie
she's
star.
Right. That's our movie star. Oh. It's our femme fatale over there. She's going over to kick some more ass.
Yeah, she's like, I heard there was a big guy here with a knife. I'm just going to kick his ass.
I'm anxiously anticipating the release of Metal Gear 5, The Phantom Pain. When Ground Zero was released, I was like, oh, that's awesome. And then Phantom Pain is supposedly not out for like 2 years.
But if you're a Deadpool fan, Daniel Way wrote the Deadpool video game. Literally like jumping into the comic book. Like he actually takes a sword and shoves it up Mr. Sinister's ass.
Spoiler alert.
No reason to buy the game, right?
And he's very romantically inspired towards Cable, which is I always wonder
right?
about those two, right?
Why
Cable and Deadpool?
He's pansexual, it's totally cool. What's that? Is that
that's Deadpool and Cable trying to figure it out.
That's appropriate-ish.
Cool, they're wrapping me.
And on that note.
It was great talking to you.
Okay.